Good afternoon. My name is Dwight Parrish, and I want to welcome you to graduation day at Stark State College. Let me begin by congratulating the class of fall 2020. COVID-19 introduced many challenges this school year, which include safety, online learning, and isolation. But it also introduced perseverance, the ability to keep doing something in spite of the obstacles. Your ability to rise above the things that bring you down is cause for celebration. And today, we celebrate with you. As a 1982 graduate of Stark State College, I want to welcome the class of fall 2020 as fellow Stark State College alumni. Please join me in helping others succeed by giving back through the Stark State College Foundation and engaging with the Alumni Association. Now, to begin our official ceremony, I'd like to turn it over to Dr. Leda Gibson Shreve. Just remember, obstacles can't stop you if you keep moving.
Hello, graduates, family members, and friends. What a year we have had at Stark State, in Ohio, and our nation. We can spend time talking about the many losses that you've experienced and the challenges that we've all faced. But I prefer to focus on the strengths and the positive characteristics that have been gained over the past several months. You've moved from the title of student to that of graduate. I'm sure you spent many hours on the computer, in Zoom rooms, and possibly chat rooms. You gained technical skills that will carry with you in your chosen career pathway, or will assist you if you're continuing your education. It's skill sets that have changed the economy as we see it today, the workplace and the world. And just imagine, you were a part of that significant change. I'm sure many of you spent time in the classroom from your bedroom, possibly at the kitchen table, and for some of you, you may have had your children or your grandchildren beside you as if they were students in the classroom with you. I hope that you gained many great memories from those interactions and that you can carry with you as well as others throughout your lifetime. There are additional skill sets that you've also strengthened or gained throughout the process. Skill sets of persistence, determination, flexibility, and resilience, among many others. Great skill sets that you will be able to utilize in the workplace and throughout your lifetime. While we would have preferred to have everyone on campus and enjoying many great memories with you, I'm pleased that everyone remains safe while continuing pursuit of your dreams. So from me to you, I ask you to virtually move your tassel from right to left, and then I'm joining you as you toss your cap in the air in enjoyment and celebration of your graduation. Congratulations to you, best wishes, and happy holidays to you and your family. I would now like to introduce Dr. Para Jones, president of Stark State College. Prior to hearing from Dr. Jones, there are faculty and staff who also want to send congratulatory messages to you. Thank you, best wishes.
I wanted to take a moment to wish all of our graduates a huge congratulations. We're all so very proud of your accomplishments, especially in this most challenging environment. Again, congratulations, and we wish you the best of luck in the future.
I want to personally congratulate each one of you on your successful completion of your programs. This semester definitely had many challenges. However, you all stayed focused on your educational goals. We are all very proud of your accomplishments and wish you the very best. Stay safe and take time to celebrate your success. You did it.
This is the class of 2020. You've worked hard to achieve your goals. I wish you a successful career and a bright future. Celebrate your accomplishments. Never stop learning. Congratulations and best of luck.
Congratulations, graduates. I wish you health and prosperity throughout your life and career.
On behalf of all the faculty and staff in the Business and Information Technology Division, congratulations and welcome to the Stark State family.
I want to take a moment and say congratulations to the class of 2020. Congratulations on all of your accomplishments and all that you have yet to do. You'll be representing Stark State College, and we wish you the very best.
I just want to take a moment to say congratulations. You did it. Great job.
On behalf of the faculty and staff in the Arts and Sciences Division, I'd like to extend a congratulations on your earned degree and wish you future success.
Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Federia Nicholson-Sweebel, and I'm the Dean of Student Success at Stark State College. I am so excited to congratulate each of our graduates on this tremendous accomplishment that you have each made. We know this has been a tough year, but you did it. You persevered, and you made it through to the finish line. Congratulations to each of you. We wish you the very best and look forward to hearing more about you as you become a Stark State College alumni. Thank you.
Congratulations to this year's graduates. You did it.
Hi, it's Danette Bosch Alexander from Education and Social Sciences. It's been a challenging year, but you did it. Congratulations on graduation.
Hi, Stark State graduates. I'm so proud of you. You did it. And a special congratulations to all my HIM students.
Congratulations to all of our graduates. I wish you the best in all of your future endeavors. A special shout out to our respiratory care students for a job well done.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You made it.
Graduate, congratulations. The best is yet to come.
Congratulations, graduates, and great luck to you.
Congrats, grads.
I just want to say congratulations to all of the Stark State graduates, and in particular to the Respiratory Care Program graduates, and I look forward to seeing you guys on the front lines of our local hospitals as essential workers.
Congratulations on a job well done. Persevered through a very, very tough time, and you know, now all you have left is to go out and save the world. No pressure. Congratulations.
You have faced much adversity in your final semester at the college. You have applied your knowledge, skills, and abilities to assist you to completion. Those KSAs will assist you in the future. Congratulations to the 2020 graduates.
Center, well done on your graduation. Best wishes on your next adventure.
I wanted to congratulate you, and I'm looking forward to seeing you out in the field working as a certified surgical technologist.
Congratulations to the fall 2020 massage therapy class. You did it. Woo!
Congratulations, Stark State graduates. You did it. We're so proud of you.
Hey, Stark Staters. This is Sarah Klink from the Digital Library. I wanted to tell you congratulations on your graduation. Way to go.
Hats off to my criminal justice students. You guys are very special, and I'm so proud of you today.
Way to hang in there, Stark Staters. We're proud of you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You have persevered and made it to the end. And I have to give a little shout out to our nursing students. You made it! Now go get that NCLEX. Congratulations.
Congratulations, you did it. In a very real way, you enable those of us who have come before you to touch the future. Thank you for all the good things you'll do to change the world in that future.
Hey, Stark Staters, you did it. With bragging rights. I'm your librarian, Marcia Addison, and I want to remind you that you now have one of the best back in my day stories ever. You get to tell your children and your grandchildren all you had to go through to get your college degree. Now go out there and change the world.
Congratulations, dietary students. I'm very proud of you. You've accomplished all of your coursework.
Congratulations, Stark State graduates. We know the pride you are feeling right now because we are all so proud of you. Enjoy this moment and the best of luck for your future.
Great job, graduates. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Stark State graduates. Remember, education doesn't end with graduation. It's just the beginning.
Congratulations, graduates, and a special shout out to all of our medical assisting graduates. You did it.
On behalf of the Career Services Office, we want to congratulate the class of 2020. And remember, now that you're graduates, our office is still here to help. Any career assistance. Congratulations.
Class of 2020, congratulations.
Congratulations, Stark Staters. We're so proud of all your hard work and determination. Best wishes as you start your next chapter.
Congratulations to the music production and engineering graduates of 2020.
Way to go, class of 2020.
Class of 2020, Stark State College, surgical technology graduates, congratulations. Well done.
Congratulations, graduates. We're so proud of you. We knew you could do it.
Hey Stark Staters, on behalf of everyone in Disability Support Services and Military Services, we want to say congratulations. You did it.
Congratulations, Stark State graduates. You crossed the finish line. Now go out into the world and shine.
As Stark State College President and on behalf of the Stark State College Board of Trustees, congratulations to our graduates and to the families, friends, and well-wishers who have supported our graduates during their academic studies. Graduates, college is not easy. On top of the academic rigor of college, many of you have worked, taken care of families, and other responsibilities, all the while persisting in your academic and career goals at Stark State. We know that took a lot of work, commitment, and sacrifice. You gave up what you wanted to do, spend time with friends, family, go out, have fun, or just rest, for what you had to do so that you could be here today at your college graduation. We are grateful that you chose to attend Stark State College. We are grateful that you prioritized academics while juggling all the other responsibilities of your busy lives. And we are very proud of you and your academic success. Commencement, as you know, is the beginning of your new future as a college graduate. Reflect on all that you have accomplished. Your college degree is the key to your career, a better future, and a better life. Use it wisely. Build on it. Let this accomplishment inspire you to ever greater accomplishments in your career and in your life. I wish all of you the best as you enter your chosen profession, pursue further education, or both. All of us here at Stark State College believe in you and your future. Congratulations. And now it is my pleasure to introduce Dr. Brian Gerber, Professor of Social Sciences and winner of Stark State College's Distinguished Teaching Award.
Hello, I'm Dr. Brian Gerber, and it is truly a great pleasure and honor to be here today. To have this opportunity as the past year's recipient of the Distinguished Teaching Award, this is the icing on the cake. I want to thank everyone who made this possible. I want to extend a warm welcome to all the friends, families, and guests of our graduates who are watching, and greetings to all of my SSC colleagues as well. Most of all, I want to say a hearty hello to the Stark State College Fall Graduating Class of 2020. Have someone near you provide a virtual hug or pat on the back. I want you to savor this day. Feel it deep within you and soak it all in. It's truly a life-altering achievement, and you should be very proud. Today is a great day, but as is the case with all great days, tomorrow looms. The good news is, today, you're a college graduate. The bad news is, tomorrow, you're a college graduate. The expectations for you will change dramatically, and I would like to offer just a few tips to assist you in meeting and exceeding those expectations. I call them the three P's for success. Nelson Mandela once said, "There is no passion to be found in playing small, in setting for a life that is less than the one you're capable of living." My hope and wish for all of you is that your future plans include something you hold great passion for. I have been honored and blessed to have passion in my professional career, and some would consider it almost shameful, but I sometimes feel I have yet to work a day in my professional life. You can only imagine how wonderful that feels, and I'm absolutely aware of how fortunate I have been. Find your own passion and go for it. I realize there are likely many in your life pushing or pulling you in one direction or another, but is it what you want to do? The truth of the matter is that very often we do not find our passion. Our passion finds us. Our world today is in desperate need of passionate people. We need social change, political sensibility, academic reform, and a whole host of other things. Find passion in what you do every day, and no day will be wasted. The second P is pride. The term pride sometimes gets a bad rap, and probably should. There are prideful people who have no basis for that pride and use their sense of entitlement to excuse their negative and inappropriate behavior. However, the type of pride I want to instill within you today is the type described by John Maxwell as that which represents dignity and self-respect. You are the future of this community, this state, this nation, and you are needed now as much as at any time in the history of this society. Pride is being yourself regardless of who is around or is currently attempting to influence you. Bryce Courtenay tells us that pride is holding your head up when everyone else has theirs bowed. When you have pride, you can hold your head up because you have done the right thing. Those who do not build and foster positive pride within themselves do not care what they do, how others perceive them, and often are the first to quit when things get tough. The great Paul Bear Bryant once said, "If you believe in yourself and have dedication and pride and never quit, you'll be a winner. The price of victory is high, but so are the rewards." We should always take pride in our successes. However, the path to success just might be paved with pride in our failures and misgivings. This may sound a little crazy. It's in owning and embracing our failures that we find the opportunities to grow, learn, and turn those losses into victories. We simply need to spend less energy finding reasons or excuses why we can't, didn't, or otherwise failed. The energy we save can then be put into finding ways why we can, why we did, or otherwise succeeded. Have enough pride to do what's right and make your own mark on the community you live in. But when that thing called life gets in the way, and it will, as no one is immune, look inward and see what you can do differently. Archbishop Desmond Tutu and His Holiness the Dalai Lama said together, "No dark fate determines our future. We do." And I'll end with perseverance, the third P. And it goes hand in hand with pride and represents perseverance as well. I'm sorry to tell you, on this exciting day of personal triumph, you'll experience failures in the days and years to come. It's inevitable if you attempt to achieve anything worthwhile. A strong sense of perseverance is what will sustain you at these moments. It was Confucius who first told us, "Our greatest glory is not in never failing, but in rising every time we fail." As I have alluded to previously, I failed many more times than I have succeeded. And I can tell you, it makes what success I have enjoyed incredibly satisfying. My professional orientation lies in the humanistic tradition posited by Abraham Maslow. In humanism, we often talk about the hardy personality. Those who exude the qualities of the hardy personality do not see threats or roadblocks in their life. They see opportunities to learn, grow, and overcome the inevitable difficulties that come our way. This requires perseverance and the ability to recognize failure as just another bump in the road. See your failures in this manner and continue to move forward, more determined than before. The words of Benjamin Disraeli may have never rung so true. Through perseverance, many people win success out of what seemed destined to be certain failure. If you are reading between the lines, you'll quickly see that I'm not big on excuses. Over the past year, we've all had access to an immediate excuse why life is so challenging. I will acknowledge that some have had it more difficult than others, but we are all living it. Think for a moment why some have done relatively well during this time, like all of you graduates, and why some have faltered and failed. Take those lessons, hold them dear, and move forward. We are all capable of far more than we often give ourselves credit for. It may very well be that the three P's we have discussed here today, passion is the one that drives pride, and perseverance. We live in an age relatively devoid of passion, at least for things that really matter, and unless things get really bad. I am probably making a value judgment here, but passion for video games, television shows, or what the latest star or starlet is up to do little to further humanity and improve the condition of the world we live in. One of my greatest passions includes all of you. You are the future and have the power to dictate what our culture and the world becomes. I have a sincere investment in your success. To paraphrase Albert Einstein, I have no special talents. It's passion that drives me. Have passion, demonstrate pride in yourself, and persevere through the things life throws at you. I'm going to wrap things up here, and applause is optional. Regardless of what tomorrow brings, and whatever it is you choose to do with your life, attempt to do it better than anyone else. Contribute positively to your community, and respect those around you. Find your passion and go for it. Don't let disappointments and perceived failures stop you from being who and what you want to be. Again, I'm honored to be here today to share in your accomplishment and hope there are many more accomplishments to come. I wish you all the very best.